Alright, let's remove this big stone here. It looks pretty big, so we'll take care of it. Now, first things first, we're going to start clearing all this out. We will grab a base. This will do. I think what we should do is we should split it up. Alright. Whenever you guys see us form, you're always going to see these wax here. Okay? Every place you go, you're always going to see this. Gotta get these bees going. I think my storage shed is the best place for them to be at. Mm-hmm. All right, so what we'll do is we'll set up one box here and one box up here. Like we used to say in the military, you gotta adapt and overcome. Since I got a bunch of queens in my other boxes that we're actually setting up, what we'll do is we'll split this swarm into two, with the idea that we'll make two hives out of it. Another thing that I could do here is I could go ahead and vacuum them up with my B-Vac, but I don't think it's necessary. And what we'll do is we'll leave the shed open for the day, and then we'll go ahead and remove it this evening. Why they're all over this thing is because it's full of honey. So now we gotta drop bees evenly. And in they go. So what we'll probably end up doing is we'll fill up one box, we'll take that box out, and then leave one more box behind. That way they can all go to that box. Because what happens is, if we leave both boxes and the queen is next to it, they all go to that box. We are almost done here. Now, always the best thing would be to find a queen and just drop her in there. But in this case, in this situation, given we probably won't. More likely she's already inside the one of these boxes here. we'll take this box, we'll relocate it, and then we'll leave the other box behind. And what we'll also do is, we'll also check to see which box doesn't have the queen, and we'll drop a cell in there, or a new mated queen, one of the ones we got. Hive beetle trap. Gotta be comfortable with bees all over you, so if you're not, and you start panicking, more likely they'll sting you.